Nestled in the heart of Midtown Atlanta, the Museum of Contemporary Art of Georgia, or MOCA GA, is home to a unique collection of more than 250 works of art. MOCA GA shares the history, diversity, and depth of contemporary art of the state, and highlights the impact of Georgia artists on the national scene. As Georgia continues to produce visual artists of incredible skill, MOCA GA provides a permanent home to their art and a means of celebrating them with the public. Georgia artist Benny Andrews honored MOCA GA with an inaugural print for the museum's opening and granted a perfect symbol of the museum's mission. His commissioned print entitled Museumscape captures a sense of art history as well as a vision for Georgia's artistic future. A Georgia native with an artistic career spanning over 50 years, Benny Andrews has impacted contemporary art nationwide. Benny Andrews refuses to fit into one simple category. He is not simply a Southern artist, or a Black artist, a realist artist, or a collage artist. He is a complex contemporary American artist of many mediums and distinct subjects. Born in Plainview, Georgia in 1930, he worked against the limits of a racially structured society to pursue his passion. The son of cotton sharecroppers and the first of 10 children to graduate from high school, he was always an artist. Benny's distinctive family history and strong sense of artistic and civic responsibility contribute to his unique vision. Art was the way Benny played as a child, how he supported himself, and how he processed the socio-political happenings of the world. To complete the commissioned artwork for MOCA GA, Benny visited Rolling Stone Press, where he collaborated with master lithographer Wayne Kline in the creation of the final print.
I'm here. Hey, Wayne.
Benny.
I'm here. Hey, look at this place. Wow. This is a real gallery.
I didn't think I left that door open.
Hey, how are you doing, buddy?
Doing good. Doing
I'm
good.
All by your place.
Located in Northeast Atlanta, Rolling Stone Press is a lithography atelier, a workshop where original, hand-printed, museum-quality lithographs are created. Wayne and Benny had collaborated before on a print entitled Thanks, and 15 years later, they joined talents again to complete the lithograph of Museumscape. The idea for Museumscape came from a larger scape series that was initially dedicated to exterior scenes. Museumscape, created especially for MOCA GA, became the first in a series of interior scenes.
So when we came to you and asked you to do the inaugural print for the opening of MOCA GA, you were already working on the interiors?
I was only thinking about it.
So this kicked it off.
Uh-huh. This kicked it off. So then I decided I'd do this. That drawing kicked it off, and then I decided that's the first work I did for the, in this case, a Museumscape, which is your print. Mm-hmm. And then from there, I was off and winging. Because, mm-hmm. See, by doing the museum, it gave me an idea of working on the inside of a space. I like to do people doing things. So in this case, they're looking, and then the personalities, whoever they are, come out where they are, you know, and they're different characters, you know, and you look at different ones. And they're kind of like this cross-section of people that view museums.
That's great. So we kicked off this whole series.
Right.
Wonderful.
See,
I like that.
See, this is off of New York. See, yeah. Instead of New York doing it, Georgia did it. So, yeah.
There we go.
Lithography is a medium well-suited for the scape series Benny has created. Several steps go into making a lithographic print. Benny first created an original drawing using pens and colored pencils.
This is my pen and ink, which is much easier for me to do than to do with litho. So I'm counting on you to come and show me how to transfer this in terms of litho. And the problem, you can't get those little marks with those big old fat thumb type pencils that you guys have that you can get with a crow quill.
Right,
I mean, that's okay, but I mean, it's not, you know.
Right, you're not going to get the same kind of sharp line that you get from the pen and ink work, but we can work with the harder number pencils, the number four pencils, and I'll keep them sharp for you, keep a good tip on it.
So the problem's going to be for me to get spontaneous. Well, you're sitting there like I'm a surgeon and you're a nurse and you're handing me these sharpened pencils like they're surgical tools. And for me to forget that, and I'll just say a number four, And you know, you'll have a mask on it, and you hand me a number four, like there'd be scissors. But I mean, okay, so we can try it. And if it doesn't work, we can start over from square one, right?
Since lithography is a chemical process based on the repulsion of water and grease, the drawing had to then be traced onto aluminum plates using special greasy lithographic pencils.
Am I taking just one color out of this now?
Now you're doing the black.
Okay, so that'll
be similar to your drawing.
Okay.
It'll be the key image, have all the details, set the composition, and then we'll tie the colors into them from the Mylar on another aluminum plate. We'll go with the yellow next.
Okay, so first I'm doing the black, so that's like my underpinning, that's my basic thing in this case.
Right.
Okay, though. Now you can go look out the window for about 10 minutes while I do this.
Okay.
Each color must be traced separately onto separate plates. Once the artist completes a trace for each color, he works with a printer to choose the right colors in ink for the final print.
So we'll start with a small amount of transparent base.
That's your palette, in other words, right there.
Right. We'll start, we'll say that's a part, one part.
Oh, so you just have it down like a cook. You can just tell when it's to taste, in other words. So that's when you say a part, you just have a kind of a 25-year experience of what a part amounts to off that little spatula.
Right, and a part can be any size you want depending on the job you're doing.
Like a chef here, look at that.
Oh, yeah. That's a Japanese
French cook. Oh, no, a French pastry. This is French pastry. Oh. Asparagus off the side there, not on a nice plate, three little asparagus, a little white cream across the top of the asparagus, and you bring this little piece of meat there.
Okay. So that'll be yours. You can hold it up to the light and get a sense.
Now, you know, yeah, when you hold it up to the light, you really can see the difference.
It shows the translucent.
Yeah.
A large part of the printer's skill is to perfectly match the ink to the color in the original drawing. The resulting color trial proofs are then judged by the artist and adjusted appropriately.
And from the last base to the first.
Yeah, it's like Christmas, right? Opening up the gift. This leads to Santa Claus's packages. Oh, wow. Well, that's it, huh?
And these were the first proofs.
Uh-huh. Now, what you said about the blue?
Yeah, we were going to make the blue darker. These are color trial proofs from the first, and then this is an artist proof.
Oh, this
see
is
the darker
yeah,
blue right
yeah,
there.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Wow. It's amazing. It came together.
Looks great.
Yeah,
looks
right.
Great.
It looks good to me, because I'm prejudiced.
Me too.
Yeah.
Well, me too.
Between you and we ought to wait for the general public, the and Annette and the people over at the museum to be okay.
Wow.
So you have how many you have here?
About 120.
Oh, really?
About 120 good ones.
Well, you whip that out in what, about 2 days?
Invented more than 200 years ago with Jurassic-era limestone found in Bavaria, Germany, the process of lithography has remained basically the same. Lithography is a physically demanding process, but it's also a delicate art form requiring much finesse.
So I tell them it's very much like playing a musical instrument. What you do to it, that instrument responds to your touch and your pressure and everything else, and this is exactly the same way.
The first step in the process is to prepare the limestone for printing by pouring a gum arabic solution over it. This eases water absorption into the clean surface. As the water is spread across the stone, it is naturally repelled from the areas contaminated by greasy crayon. It doesn't take a great deal of water to do the trick, just enough to moisten the stone.
But you can see how the water is repelled by the greasy areas and how it's attracted to the negative areas.
All other forms of printmaking rely on something physical to separate the image area from the non-image area. Lithography is different since it relies on the natural chemistry of the materials used. An oily ink is prepared to apply across the stone with a roller. The ink adheres only to the greasy trace and is repelled by the wet parts of the stone.
So it goes through that metamorphosis of just being a greasy drawing on top of the stone to an image that's held within the surface of the stone. And it actually forms a grease reservoir within the surface of the stone.
Once the stone is dampened and inked, it is covered with a clean sheet of paper and pushed through a hand-press trolley. The actual print is made as the press exerts 4,000 to 5,000 pounds of pressure onto the stone. Only one print can be pressed at a time, and only one color can be printed at a time. This entire process is repeated for every color.
And the final color. Voila.
Each print is considered an original since it is created by the artist's own trace, and because the printer presses each one individually by hand. So while each print in the edition is essentially the same, there may be subtle differences. What makes a print especially unique is the artist's signature, and Benny kept good humor during his autographing session.
You do have this down to science. I like your system.
It works.
Down to the nitty gritty here.
So what began as Benny's drawing became 100 vibrant, original lithographic prints for the museum.
But really, it's an honor to be working with you guys. You're easy.
So pleased.
We're learning from these New Yorkers, though.
Well, New Yorkers. I mean, people ask me, I'm from Georgia. I'm from Georgia. Once you're from Georgia, you're always from Georgia.
A successful collaboration between an artist and a printer makes each of their individual talents shine.
So tell me what it was like for you two guys to work together in a collaboration.
I never worked with anyone who worked this concentrated and worked this long. In terms of from detail to detail, they're working with Wayne. And the thing that was good about Wayne is that he was not, he didn't argue about anything, but he was very nice and persuasive in saying, well, you know, maybe you want to do a little of this, because I'm very sensitive and ego-centered about, I know what I want to do. And sure. I don't take information easily. But in his case, I didn't know the profession. Mm-hmm. I didn't know the techniques and things.
Had you done a lot of prints?
I've done a lot of prints, especially etchings, but not, I've done, no, I think, two or three lithographs.
We did that one lithograph, right. 15 years ago.
In the past, I hadn't really put much thought into it, and I wouldn't put that much thought into this if it hadn't been for him, because he'd just tell me more things that could be done, like, for example, the different pencils and it, you know, the different sizes and things, and also what happens in the transfer, you know, the pencil line, whatever, to the plate and what happens like that. And he walked me through every movement, everything. He walked me through it and he'd explain it and he walked me back and he thought, and it was really more work than I intended to do. It's like throwing down to the catcher. So he's the catcher and he said, a little on that side, a little over all, I want to do it on. And then you wind up out there and you give it to him. So there's this combination like that. And I mean, all collaborations, if they work like that, you know, you talk about mates or whatever you want to say, it's the ability for both people to bring their talents together and you know, make something like the old cliche about the whole equal more than the parts. And so that's what we have hoped to do, that, you know, I was doing this print and he brings his skill and we hope it ends up being more than if I did it by myself or he just ran off his colors. See, this was great to work on. You know, because it was like, and I like new things. You know, this is an innovative thing, and so this has a beginning, and with all the adventure and all of the wonderful things and all the pitfalls down the road and all that kind of stuff. It's, you know, it's like live vicariously through the opening of this thing. And so this is great. So I'm enjoying this. Now, what's going to happen later, you know, the old Marine and I will get together and we'll talk about it.